Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build a rather simple 1-byte tileable sand column counter that can either count upwards or downwards depending on its setup, and is basically a simplified version of the sand column counter I showed in a previous tutorial. But anyway, let's show this in action. So down here I have a lever as an input for this example here. You can also use just an observer running into this line of power rails here. And every activation, the sand gets shifted from the back towards the front. Since the column is 10 high, this can count up to 10, you would think, but at 10 it automatically resets, as you will see in a moment. And just one more. And as you can see, the next module automatically gets activated. So those can be chained together, and in this case I have a counter that can count from 0 up to 999. And a pretty compact design actually. The only limitation for this upwards counter here is that it can only work with one activation every 1.1 seconds or slower. If you are going faster, it will break when the system is resetting it. For the downwards counter it works pretty similar, but this time it's shifting the sand from the front towards the back, as you can see there. The maximum frequency here is one activation every second, so it's a tiny bit faster, as you can see there, as the upwards counter. And once more, as you can see, those are chained together, this time not right to left, but left to right, so you can chain them in any direction you want. And as you can see, it works like it's supposed to. So anyway, let's start with the sizes. As I mentioned, those are much more compact than the last version. In total, they are 6 blocks long. For the downwards counter, it's actually more or less just 5 blocks plus a bit of immovable block at the front. They are, as I mentioned, 1 block wide, each module, and the height is 18 blocks in total, so much smaller than before. And that's the sizes. Now let's talk about the required resources. So for the upwards counter, you're gonna need, of course, building blocks, then one obsidian block, the 14 sand blocks, one redstone repeater, then 15 observers, 2 power drills, a node block, a piston, 12 sticky pistons, 4 fence gates, the lever is here as an input, and if you want to chain more modules together, for each chain you need a repeater, 2 observers, a normal piston and a sticky piston. And that's the required resources for this version there. And for the other version it's almost the same, basically just the difference is the repeater here. So again, blocks, obsidian, 14 sand, 15 observers, 2 power drills, node block, 11 pistons this time, 2 sticky pistons, so basically 10 sticky pistons became normal pistons here, 4 fence gates, the lever is input again, and to chain them together it's again 2 observers, a sticky piston and a normal piston, no repeater this time. And that's basically all you're gonna need. So let's show you how to build those 2 versions here. Okay, so let's build one module of the upwards counter. For that we start with those 3 blocks here. So at the floor level we have the block in front of the sand column and behind it, and below the second we have an immovable block like obsidian. That's our starting point. Now we go down from this front one here by 5 blocks. Add another one towards the back. Put the 2 power drills here. Since this is our input, we can place our lever here. Now place 2 observers on top of the front and 1 on top of the back power drill. In this corner we need a normal piston, then a sticky piston here, then a full block right in this gap there. Now grab 10 sticky pistons and place them in the column here. Like so. Then let's go and place a normal block diagonal to the sticky piston there. an observer on top with another block on top. Take an output from that one with a repeater, which runs directly into another sticky piston with an observer in front of it. Diagonal to that, we need again a normal block with a node block this time below it. Then we have observer parsing off and down. And now we have essentially a repeating pattern of fence gate, observer parsing off, and observer parsing downwards towards the next fence gate. And of course you stop once you have powered all sticky pistons, like so. And that's the module more or less done. Now let's start filling in the sand. You could do this with a 2x2 here and then a column of 10 on top of that. Or if you want to use two colors, I recommend the following setup. Two of one color at the bottom, then two of the other on top, with a third one here. And then you have an alternating pattern of two of each color, as you can see there. And let's give it a little test run. And as you can see, it works. And that's one module done. Now let's build a few more modules and then let's show you how you can chain them together. And voila! So now we have three modules in total, and next step is chaining them together. I want this one here to stay the input one, so I have to chain them from right to left. And the way to do this is rather simple. We start with the one where we want the chain to start from, place an observer there, then diagonal to that we need a sticky piston facing downwards, with an observer powering in the direction we want to chain into. Then from this observer we go down two blocks and towards the next module with a normal piston. Then we have an observer looking in the space where the piston arm will extend into. Next we need a repeater taking an output from the observer and running into a full block, which then will power the next module. And that we need in this case to repeat another time, because obviously we have two modules we want to chain. And then last part is of course giving it a little test run. Remember that the maximum frequency you can use here when the entire thing has counted to 10 is one activation every 1.1 seconds. Otherwise, as you can see, there is a good chance that part of it will self-destruct. But as you can see, besides of this little mishap here, the thing is not working, which means it's time to start building the downwards counter. So next, let's start with the first module for the downwards counter. For that, we start with those three blocks you can see here. In front of the future sand column and behind it, at the floor level, we have normal blocks, below the front one an immovable block like obsidian. Then we go below the back one by five blocks. Then one towards the front. Place down the two power trails. Since this is our input, let's place the lever here. Then grab some observers, place them like here. In this corner we need a normal piston, in this gap a sticky piston, and in this gap a normal block. Then grab 10 normal pistons and place them in a column here. Next grab an observer, place it diagonal to this last piston, place a full block on top, sticky piston towards the side with an observer facing downwards there. Diagonal to that we need a normal block with a node block below it, then observer going in the direction of the pistons and downwards. And then essentially we have a repeating pattern of fence gate, observer branching off and going down towards the next fence gate, until you reach the point where all pistons are powered via those observers there. Next we can start filling in the sand columns. For that you can either use just one color, then it's the 2x2 here and then a column of 10 there. Or you can go and first place two of one color, then two of another color, third one there, and then you have an alternating pattern of two of each color, and if you place the last one there, it should reset, as you can see there. And that's one module done. Next step is copying this a few more times, and then I will show you how you can chain them together. So now that I have three modules in total, it's time to chain them together. I want this one here to remain the main input, so I will have to chain them from left to right. For that, I start with the first module in the chain, take an output with an observer from this last piston there. Directly down, we need a sticky piston with an observer, which is powering in the direction I want to chain into. Then I go down by two blocks and towards the module I want to chain into with a normal piston facing downwards. And then in the space where the observer or the piston arm will extend into, I place an observer, which then powers directly the next module. And that's already the entire thing done. So all I have to do is copy this one more time. And now I have chained all three together. And with that, it's time to give a little test run. So let's see if everything works. Remember, the maximum frequency here is one activation every second, or the system might self-destruct at some point. And one more. And as you can see, the chaining works. And that was basically how you can build those two rather simple, one-byte tileable upwards and downwards sand column counters. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!